night. And once again, the nightly grapple with death. The room shaking with demonic orchestras. The snatches of fearful sleep. The voices outside the window. My name being continually repeated with scorn by imaginary parties arriving. The dark spinets. As if there were not enough real noises in these nights, the color of gray hair. Not like the rending tumult of American cities. The unbandaging of great giants in agony. But the howling pariah dogs, the cocks that herald dawn all night, the drumming, the moaning that will be found later, white plumage huddled on telegraph wires in back gardens. Fowl roosting in apple trees. The eternal sorrow that never sleeps. Of great mystery. For myself, I like to take my sorrow into the shadows of old monasteries, my guilt into cloisters, and under tapestries, and into the misericordies of unimaginable cantinas, where sad-faced potters and legless beggars drink at dawn, whose cold, jonquil beauty one rediscovers in death. So, but when you left, Yvonne, I went to Oaxaca. There is no sadder word. Shall I tell you, Yvonne, of the terrible journey there through the desert, over the narrow gauge railway, on the rack of the third-class carriage bench? The child whose life its mother and I saved by rubbing its belly with tequila out of my bottle, or of how, when I went to my room in the hotel where we once were happy, the noise of slaughtering below in the kitchen drove me out into the glare of the street. And later, that night, there was a vulture sitting in the wash basin. Horrors portioned to a giant nerve. Secrets are of the grave and must be kept. And this is how I sometimes think of myself, as a great explorer who has discovered some extraordinary land from which he can never return to give his knowledge to the world. But the name of this land is Hell. It is not Mexico, of course, but in the heart. And today I was in Cuanahuac, as usual, when I received from my lawyers news of our divorce. This was as I invited it. I received other news, too. England is breaking off diplomatic relations with Mexico, And all her consuls, those, that is, who are English, are being called home. These are kindly and good men, for the most part, whose name, I suppose, I demean. I shall perhaps go home, but not to England, not to that home. So, at midnight, I drove in the Plymouth to see my friend Cervantes, the cockfighter, at the Salon Ophelia, and thence I came to the Farolito in Paria, where I sit now in a little room off the bar at 4:30 in the morning, drinking hojas, and then mezcal, and writing this on some Bella Vista notepaper I filched the other night. Perhaps because the writing paper at the consulate, which is a tomb, hurts me to look at. I think I know a good deal about physical suffering, but this is worst of all, to feel your soul dying. I wonder if it is because tonight my soul has really died, that I feel at the moment something like peace.